And now we'd like to welcome Tim from the Rochester Museum and Science Center to the show. Hi, Tim.
Hey, guys. How are we doing?
So what do you got for us today?
Today we've got Froggerick Douglas with us.
Froggerick Douglas. Cool.
And he is a smooth-sided toad.
All right.
Okay. Now, what is the difference between a frog and a toad?
Well, now, the thing with frogs and toads, all toads are frogs, but not all frogs are toads.
Okay.
Okay.
And so whenever you see a toad on the ground, someone will go, oh, that's a frog. You'll know that's a toad. No, it's a frog. But toads are different. A lot of things are different. Like, mostly they have stubbier, shorter legs, so they're not as big jumpers most of the time.
Okay.
They also don't have any teeth. They usually use their sticky tongue to snag whatever it is they're eating, and they swallow it whole.
Okay.
So that's your really big difference between them.
So where are we going to find this toad living in the wild?
He's on a bunch of different continents that he's indigenous to, but you'll find him a lot of times in places like Chile, Brazil, down in South America. He likes to be in climates that are either tropical or subtropical.
So not Rochester.
So no, he's probably not hanging
out
in Rochester.
Not on a daily like today, though.
No, oh, he would like it today. He'd be out, he'd be chilling.
Right.
All right, so what is an indicator species and what makes amphibians like this one good indicators?
Well, an indicator species is a species that can tell you about the ecosystem, about how it's doing, by how they're doing, how their population is, and what kind of condition they're in. As you notice, I'm using
some
plastic gloves.
Sure.
That's because Froderick here, he turns, oh.
He's talking.
Yep, he was telling you that he's got very sensitive skin.
Okay.
And he actually drinks through his skin. He absorbs his moisture through the skin. So any of the impurities that might be on my hands or any of the pollutants that are in the ecosystem,
sure,
in the water or in the, he likes to be under the leaves and in the wet ground. If there's some impurities there, then he takes those in, and that's what's going to be the big indicator is how he's doing. And these guys actually are losing, especially in South America and in the Amazon and whatnot, they're losing a lot of their habitat, so that's their biggest problem.
So this guy, because he's a pretty big frog, what kind of predators is he going to have?
Actually, he doesn't have many at all.
Really?
Because, well, behind his eyes, you can see that he's got some glands, and those glands release buffotoxin.
Buffotoxin.
Buffo, B-U-F-O-T-O-X-I-N. Oh. And what that is if you get enough of it into you, it can actually give you a heart attack.
No kidding.
So it's usually a white type of secretion, and somehow the other predators know not to eat them, probably just through instinct as years go on.
Right.
Same way if you see the poison dart frogs.
Yes, bright colors.
They're always really bright colors.
Yes.
Bright colors, stay away from.
Sure.
Now, what does their diet consist of, and is he a good hunter?
This guy,
he says
he's as good as he needs to be. He's actually a pretty good hunter. Their diet consists of mostly insects, maybe small mammals, and so he eats mostly superworms.
How big is Frederick going
to
get?
Froggerick, he'll get about 5 to 6 inches. The female might get a little bit bigger, might get just up towards 7 inches long.
Wow.
So, and pretty good hunter.
Cool.
Now, where would our viewers have seen him
this
before?
Guy? Probably in Harry Potter.
Ah. Oh.
Because this is the same type of toad they use that they call Trevor. Here, we'll give him his little Harry Potter wand. Da da.
So he's got pretty big eyes. Does that mean he's nocturnal?
He is nocturnal. And some frogs use their eyes to actually swallow. They'll swallow, and you'll see their eyes move back, and they push the food back down with them. I don't believe he does so much.
He's casting a spell.
Yes, he's ready. He says, we're out of time.
Yes. Well, Tim, thank you very much.
Thank you.
If you would like to learn more about the Rochester Museum and Science Center and see other videos about animals, visit our website, homeworkhotline.org. And now, stay right there. We'll be back in a second.